who was Skip Prosser?
Who was Skip Prosser?
Skip Prosser was, wow. Coach Prosser was,
who was Skip Prosser?
He was a great, great coach, but he was 10 times the person he was as a coach, at least.
He was preeminently a great human being.
He was a great basketball coach, but off the floor, he was an unbelievable man.
He was 100% real.
Just the ultimate role model and just the perfect symbol of a man or what he's supposed to do.
He's a great father, okay, first and foremost.
He was like a dad to me, you know. I didn't really have a dad in my life growing up, and you know, he kind of took that role once I got here.
He is about far more than basketball.
He also, I think, had absolute integrity.
Skip believed that you wanted to be the best you can be every day.
He's a great coach, but more than that, a great human being.
He was so much fun to cover. I loved his intellectual curiosity.
I remember he once quoted Nietzsche, and you don't think of a German philosopher appearing in a sports column.
He would use words I had no idea what they meant. I would nod yes and act like I knew what he was talking about, and then I'd go home and look up the word.
Skip's one of those guys that made you carry a dictionary in your backpack, not that every journalist shouldn't.
He was one of the most brilliant people I've ever known.
He had that gift of talking to people and just automatically connecting with you.
I mean, he was a guy that never put himself first. He always put others ahead of himself.
There may be some people who don't like Skip, but I never met him.
He was one of my favorite guys. He's somebody that, you know, stays in your heart.
Skip was a great guy. He was my man.
Skip believed that you wanted to be the best you can be every day.
He was just so solid. You could count on him every day.
He was a head basketball coach at the highest level of college basketball. But he thought of himself as a teacher first.
Many coaches talk about coaching as being an educator or being a teacher. Well, Skip actually lived it. I mean, every single day he lived that role of coach as teacher.
The greatest teacher that I ever had was the one I had from 3 o'clock to 5:30 every single day at Schmidfield House in practice, and that was Coach Prosser.
Coach Prosser told me one day, he said, making it to the NBA is as easy as ABC, and I was like, what in the world is Coach talking about?
Coach Prosser was big on the ABCs.
And even at his camps, the same things he shared with his players, he shared with young children. They just were a part of his life about ABC, academics, basketball, and character.
He told the kids, you know, A is for academics.
Skip told me about how you have to come here, you have to have good A for academics.
Make sure you're doing right in school, you know, that's what you're here for. That's gonna, you know, help you later in life, academics.
Academics in my life is probably much more important than basketball will ever be. That's why I'm here at Wake Forest, to get my 4-year degree, and outside of basketball, do something great in the community, or just help impact someone else's life.
Even when we were at Xavier, you know, the first thing we would talk about every day was academics.
He talked about academics every single day. It was the first thing that he talked about with his team.
Number one, academics.
Nobody in my family had ever graduated college, and you know, that's something I wanted to do for, you know, myself and my mom and my dad. And you know, that's one thing that he promised, that I would graduate from Wake Forest with a degree.
And it was one of Skip's sources of pride was that the basketball players that he taught, almost without exception, did stay and graduate.
Well, we have one of the highest graduation percentages in the country for our basketball program.
There's not a lot of teams that can say they graduate all their seniors.
We had a lot of success with graduating players.
It feels really, really good to know that all those things he instilled in you, May 17th, you're gonna be walking across that stage.
The only person in my family, you know, to get a degree, so that's huge in itself. And then, for us to complete the cycle for Coach Prosser, you know, that's amazing, you know.
He's gonna be walking across that stage with me, so I carry him in my heart,
And I mean, that diploma is just a sign, a symbol, and a tribute to it, you know, the dedication he has to us.
When we get to turn our tassel to the other side, that's what it's all about. That was the goal for Coach Prosser from day one.
Would stop a practice, stop a drill, bring the team in and teach. You know, and not necessarily just X's and O's. He might throw in a life lesson here or there.
The A stands for academics.
I had my first middle school report card and got all A's in it.
Academic always comes first.
Whenever I talk about the ABCs, I'm not just saying it, because I know when Coach said it to me, he wasn't just saying it to be telling me, like he truly meant it. When I tell these kids, it's the same thing.
He said the B stands for basketball.
B stands for basketball.
Skip loved basketball.
Not only are you taking on your family, you're taking on all these kids, and you've told their parents that you're going to take care of them.
I told Skip, I said, we're giving our son to you. You know, you've got to take care of him.
We're going to become one of the best programs in the United States, and this is how we're going to do it. We're going to play hard. We're going to play smart. We're going to play together.
And he said the C stands for character.
C is the most important. He says your academics is great and your basketball's great, but your character is what counts the most.
Skip was a guy that cared about not only the academic success of these players and the athletic success, but he cared about their character, and I think he demanded excellence in all three areas.
Skip believed in doing things for other people without looking for anything in return.
It's great when you have players go to the NBA, but it's also great when you have a player become a doctor or go into another profession, become a policeman, get a master's, get a doctorate, become a good father, build a house for your family.
But he said, honestly, if there's one thing that I enjoy the most, it's the father-son camp. And he talked about his sons and his family and how important it is. And you could really tell that he really, really meant it and lived it. And I remember one of the sayings that stays with me to this day that we met and he spoke about was, don't delay gratification. Meaning, don't forget to tell your kids and your family that you love them. Just a great life's lessons that had nothing to do with basketball, but I know it affected so many people in that room.
You could just tell there was a pep in his step, there was a twinkle in his eye, there was an excitement about him when his boys were around.
Skip found time every single day to be in touch with his sons, and that's very few fathers do that. Period.
Sitting on the bench, you get to see a lot about Skip. And when the lights would go down, he would come over and hug Scott. Just a really great moment. And Scott would hug him back.
And I know he was tremendously proud of both of his sons. Mark, of course, followed in his footsteps coaching. And there are a lot of people in Winston-Salem who would like to see him here on the staff one day.
And I cherish every single second that I have to play with my girls, and a lot of it is because of, you know, the love he had for his sons.
Grandma Joe, it was just that was Skip's kind of gentler side, the caring, the loving, the doing things for other people. I think that's where a lot of that came from.
I think Grandma Joe gave us insight into why Skip was like he was. She's friendly. She knows everyone. She loves children. She loves to read. A lot of the traits that Skip had were certainly, you could see him in her or her in him.
Grandma Jo is, you know, Skip used to say all the time, and he's right, she's saintly. She's saintly.
He cared about people. He cared about the influence that he could have. He got every bit of juice and pulp out of the fruit of life.
And it was that combination of character with coaching, with learning, which made him very special.
The perfect man. Simple and plain. The perfect citizen, perfect role model, the perfect father, the great husband. An exceptional coach and just all around caring man.
Skip Prosser was a very, very interesting person who happened to be a basketball coach.
And he had that big picture. He knew that basketball wasn't everything.
There was no ifs, ands, and buts. Skip was a good guy.
I miss the person. And that is the central fact, isn't it, about anybody? More than degrees or written qualifications?
Skip was the dad that I never knew. He was the brother that was next door.
No matter what I do as I move forward, I want to have the type of profound influence on the people I come in contact with in the same way Skip Prosser had an influence on me.
I wouldn't trade that 1 year with him with any college coach, NBA coach, for 4 years. He was that special to me, and I'm just happy that I had him for 1 year, because that 1 year lasts forever.
You know, at the end of the day, I hope I can be half the man that Skip Prosser was. If I can look back on my life and know that I touched as many people that he did, and know that because of him, I'm a better person, I couldn't ask for anything more.
Anytime you're around Skip Prosser, he made you feel special. And he's just one of those guys that I'll never forget and that I miss a lot.
No matter what I do or what I accomplish, you know, I'll always be, you know, that walk-on from Xavier University that Skip Prosser gave a chance to. And I'll treat everybody like Skip Prosser treated them. That's like they were the most important person in the world.
You know, people like that don't come around too often.
He told me, in order to be successful, he said it's as easy as ABC and you have to go in that order. He said the A stands for academics. He said the B stands for basketball. And he said the C stands for character, right? So if you guys remember that, I guarantee you it'll take you further than anything else will ever take you in life. And notice that it wasn't BAC, it was ABC. So the academics and your schoolwork comes before any of this stuff ever has a chance, all right?
Who was Skip Prosser?